What do we talk about? You know what I did? I just Googled, and you probably guess what I Googled on the left side and what I Googled on the right side: land degradation, healthy soils, because I thought, yes, should start with definitions. And well, what by the way, what struck me is the difference in colors, the difference in colors when on Google you want to image what is land degradation and what are healthy soils. And you see, of course, that arid conditions, desertification are very well, erosion are strongly represented with land degradation. Indeed, land degradation are the many processes that drive the decline or loss in biodiversity, ecosystem functions, or their benefits to people, and include the degradation of all terrestrial ecosystems as defined by IPBES. While soil health is the continued capacity of soil to support ecosystem services. So kind of mirror, partly mirror, maybe my colleague Isabelle Cousin would say two sides of the same coin, but well, there's land on the one side and soils on the other one. Now, today we have clear targets regarding land degradation and healthy soils. One of them, and the maybe the first one historically, is the one related to sustainable development goals, life on land, where target 15.3 says, announces that by 2030, to combat desertification, restore degraded land and soil, including land affected by desertification, drought and floods, and strive to achieve a land degradation neutral world. So a clear target, but now, I will just take three examples. If you look in the literature and in the documents for different institutions, it is sometimes perturbing that the numbers are quite different. For example, there was this 1/3 of world soils are degraded by in the Status of World Soils Resource Report by ITPS. For the soil mission, the statement was, when it was launched, was that soils are threatened, 60 to 70% in all soils in Europe. And you have here a map that I took from a recent paper where you can see that part of the territory of Europe appears in green with no degradation. So what, for me, this is not controversy, but this shows that as soil land and soil degradation are multifaceted, there are different ways to measure it. There are different ways, different indicators can be used. And this, of course, rises to different numbers. And I know, for example, that the numbers, the indicators used by IPCC and those used by UNCCD and IPBES are not the same. So, of course, it leads to different numbers. So there's a strong need for a glossary, defining the terms for indicators to monitor soil degradation, land degradation, soil health, and monitoring systems. And that's the topic of today, of course. Now, in the HAP soil, we do partly contribute to this. And so what is the HAP soil? The HAP soil is a joint program. It's a co-fund action. It aims to sustain coordinated national research and innovation programs that are also coordinated, of course, with Europe. It has a critical mass, 24 countries, 26 partners, again, aims to consolidate transnational research and has the capacity, you see from the mark, to embark not all European countries, unfortunately, not all of them joined, but a large part of Europe. It is financed by public funding. For half of the budget comes from the European Commission and half comes from the research institutes, which are financed specifically for HAP soil by the governments. It works with annual programming, and we started in 2020. We will finish in 2 years, and it undergoes a wide range of activities. So the HAP soil, its long title is Towards Climate Smart and Sustainable Management of Agricultural Soils. So it is indeed focused on agricultural soils. And we developed to present and develop our activities, a knowledge framework. You see that we have activities that aim to knowledge development. That is, a lot of, we performed a lot of stock takes, a lot of inventory of the existing, and we are financing research projects. We have 23 research projects at the moment that aim to an understanding of soil management for climate change mitigation, adaptation, and sustainable production and sustainable environment, or aim to understanding soil carbon sequestration and its contribution to climate change mitigation. We also have activities that are more of knowledge sharing and transfer, especially via strengthening scientific capacities in cooperation, PhD schools, short visits, training programs. We have an important activity of knowledge harmonization, organization, and storage that aims to support harmonized European soil information, including international reporting, and knowledge application essentially is oriented towards fostering the uptake of climate smart sustainable soil management practices and developing region specific fertilization practices. And it's actually essentially and increasingly oriented towards supporting policy. So AJP Soil is really at the encounter of different challenges, and it is about healthy soils. I said in my introduction that there were a number of quantifications of soil degradation. And one thing that we did in the AJP was to try to have an assessment of the perception of these degradation and hence of the challenges of managing agricultural soils. And we performed a wide, we questioned a wide set of stakeholders who are national hubs. You have here the different categories of stakeholders, and the results are here. So challenges are answers to degradation or risk of or threats to soil. And you can see that the one that appeared most was to maintain and increase soil organic carbon. Second, enhance and nutrient retention and efficiency. And actually, I was in a sense, we were surprised because what is considered to be the main degradation, land degradation in Europe, is soil erosion. And you see, did not rank among the first. So this is different. It's perception of what are the soil challenges in facing land degradation. We are, as I said, we develop knowledge and we are financing a number of research projects and convinced several agencies, also several research funders outside of AJP Soil to finance projects in our focus. And for example, so regarding land degradation, we have especially two projects, one dealing scale with soil erosion and the other one dealing with compaction. And I would say more indirectly, we have a large number of projects that concern soil organic carbon sequestration, and some of them address directly the loss of organic matter, but most are oriented towards estimating carbon sequestration potential, understanding it, managing trade-offs between carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, and developing an MRV technology. So healthy. And relevant to today, so indicators and monitoring systems. So we have projects that are concerned with developing frameworks and indicators for soil health and land degradation, and projects that focus on innovation and methods for data acquisition, for example, proximal sensing, remote sensing, changing scales between these, upscaling, downscaling between these methods. So you see a large portfolio of projects that are really oriented towards climate smart and sustainable management of agricultural soils. Now, a few results that are relevant to this webinar today. So we contributed to the definition of soil health by placing it in regards to soil quality. We consider, and in agreement with a proposal of the Mission Board, that soil quality is the capability of soil, a given soil, soil type, a given land use, under a given climate. It's the potential, the capability, while soil health is the actual capacity of the soil that depends on its current status and ecosystem management. And there can be a reduction of ecosystem services provision related, for example, to soil degradation, to management, to climate change. And there can be an increase of ecosystem provision system ecosystem services provision beyond soil quality, but that is unsustainable somehow because it is using inputs, it is using management practices that endanger biodiversity, for example. So soil health, a healthy soil is reaching the level of soil quality. What we did also that I think is, so we need monitoring systems. So what we did in the HAP soil is that we inventoried and analyzed the existing national soil monitoring programs and compared them with the LUCAS soil monitoring program. So you see, for example, we found that there were in national soil monitoring systems in 90 countries, and we characterized them by the objective, the layout, the history, the number of sampling campaigns, sampling depth, well, a number of characteristics. So this is something that you can consult on our website. And what came out is that soil monitoring systems in Europe are very diverse protocols, very different soil parameters monitored. So in the perspective of the European Soil Observatory, where the idea is to integrate the information coming from these national soil monitoring systems with the LUCAS soil monitoring system, it is very important to develop harmonization of information. And the flow, of course, of data from these monitoring systems to the user. And there's something I would like to draw your attention to, what we are performing now, a collaboration with GRC, and we have an ongoing LUCAS AJP Soil National Soil Monitoring System intercomparison about the sampling design, the methodology for measurements, et cetera. So this should help us to integrate all these systems together. Regarding indicators for soil health and the way forward, we propose recommendations to have a tiered system of indicators. And I think that the current user dashboard really reflects that, and it's in this spirit, promote harmonization rather than standardization. We propose to have an indicator selection process that is top-down, policy relevant soil indicators for a given policy objective rather than bottom-up, to use the very pragmatic way, to use the indicators that are already used by more than 50% of member states as a minimum data set, and to associate stakeholders to the development of indicators to ensure adoption by stakeholders. So these are proposals that we made, recommendations and proposals that we made in the perspective of the soil health law. In that line, so we organized a policy workshop recently. So all presentations are available online on our website, and soon the recordings will be available. And I want to take the opportunity to tell you that we will organize a webinar still on soil health indicators in the perspective of the soil health law, discussing how do you set threshold, what are the criteria for selecting indicators, and it will be the second week of May. Now I'm coming to the end, so I'm very pleased to have introduced this, and so this was focused on the HAP soil and how do we contribute to the topic of today. But now you will have presentations more on the policy institutional context. And we are in an extremely exciting context with the preparation of the soil health law, the building up of the USO. And the second session will more concern proposals and needs. And on that, I would like to thank you for your attention.